Hello and welcome dear students to a series of grammar in use. In this video we are going to explore the ability modal. You are requested to get a pen and notepad ready so that you can take down the pointers and construct sentences as we go along. Let us dive into it. First of all, what modal is used for the ability modal? The word can is a modal verb that describes what someone is able to do. It is used in different forms to describe past and present abilities. Make a note of it, past and present only. It cannot be used for future, in the past or etc. So it is used for past and present abilities only. The first pointer that we have is can. Negative connotation is cannot, and the contraction of cannot is can't. Can goes between the subject and the main verb. I walk. I is the subject, walk is the main verb. I cannot walk. I cannot walk. So it goes in between the subject and the main verb. The verb after can goes in the base form, that means the original form without any inflection like ing, ed or s added to it. It goes in the base form. I can ride a bicycle, he can play the guitar. The base form of play and can is always the same. It doesn't change with the subject. That means no s added to it, no other inflections added to the modal. So modal remains as such and the verb remains in the base form without any inflections. These two pointers to be taken down while constructing or using can. The negative form of can is cannot or can't. I cannot sing jazz song. I can't sing jazz songs. The more common short form of cannot is can't. The tip that is that the long negative form cannot is always spelled as one word, not two words. So can not goes together as one compound word, and can't is the contraction. And remember one thing, can't is used for spoken English and cannot is written for written academic or formal English. Now for the examples that we have is with the same construction that we have seen. Janet can play tennis, ability. Bob can swim well, that is Bob's ability. Now in negative connotation, he cannot climb the tree. Remember the pronunciation of climb, be silent, climb the tree. They cannot lift the they can't lift the box. And if I were to use this sentence for writing, I will write it as they cannot lift the box. And for spoken, I will use they can't lift the box. At this point, the students are requested to pause and construct one sentence for each category and proceed. Now let us see the structure, how these sentences are formed. You can see the subject, then you have the modal, can, cannot or can't, and then the base form of the verb, and then you have the object of the sentence or the remaining part of the sentence. Then you have your first person pronoun, I and we. You is the second person pronoun. He, she, it and they are the third person pronoun. With all these subjects, it can be main verb, a noun, it can be proper noun also like John, Mary, etc. Now let us see and construct the sentence. I can ride a bicycle. You can ride a bicycle. He can ride a bicycle. She can ride a bicycle. It can ride a bicycle. We can ride a bicycle. They can ride a bicycle. So I have constructed with all the pronouns. It can be done with the negative connotation. I cannot ride a bicycle. Maybe they cannot ride a bicycle. With can't, if I were to construct, you can't ride a bicycle, we can't ride a bicycle. It goes with all the pronouns. I have not used all, but you may pause the video and try constructing all three modals with all the pronouns. Let us proceed. The next pointer that we have is that could for past abilities. Now, for past abilities, it is actually the ability in the past. Could is the past form of can and is used to talk about an ability that existed in the past. The word when plus a time setting can be used to say when someone had that ability. So that means past ability is depicted with could, and if you use the word when, you can bring in a time marker as well. Let us see the example that we have before us. I can't climb trees now, but I could when I was younger. As for the picture, if you were to see, a person cannot do it now, but when the person was younger, the person could do it. Now let us understand. I can't describes the present ability, and I could describes the past ability. The time frame can be set with the phrase about the age, day, year, etc. So time marker is essential for mentioning the ability in the past. Now let us see certain examples based on the same construction. When I was a student, I could study all night before an exam. When? Before an exam. Now, when I was student is the condition set. I could, ability, study all night before an exam is the time marker. I couldn't go to China last year, inability. When, time marker is last year, and the reason it is too expensive. When Milo was 8, condition set, time, he could, ability, play the violin, the ability. Last year she couldn't, that is negative form, inability, run very far, but yesterday she ran the marathon. So that means time marker of the past and time marker of the immediate past. That is the near past and that is a distant past. At this moment, students are requested to pause the video and construct a few sentences. The last pointer in today's lesson is can in the future. Now, we have mentioned that we cannot use can in the future. It is not grammatically possible to talk about the future using can. Will be able to is used instead of the word can. So ability in the future is depicted with the word will. At the moment, I can play the trombone quite well. If I work harder, I will be able to play at concerts. Will be able to. Will is correct and can is incorrect. Then we have the negative is formed with not able to or unable to. Unfortunately, I can't read music very well. If I don't learn, I won't be able to join the orchestra. It is very unlikely that people say, if I don't learn, I will be unable to join the orchestra. Will be unable to or can also be used, but it is less common. With this, we have come to the end of the lesson. If you have enjoyed the lesson, click on like, share and subscribe. And thank you very much for your kind attention.